Would hope that's not the start, but if it is, there they go. Where's the beef? On top by many. Class Indian follows in second place in Golden Slammer as they're spread out from the beginning. Class Indian, though, is speeding up and moving closer to Where's the Beef, who got a jump on them at the start. Where's the Beef? On top. Class Indian follows in second place. Maybe two and a half lengths separates those two. And it's a good ways back to Forest Kelly and Golden Slammer. Setting the pace, Mark Beecher on Where's the Beef, on top by maybe a length and a half to 2 lengths. Class Indian and Justin Batoff following in second place. Good ways back to Golden Slammer, who races in third. Where's the Beef, on top from the early stages. Moving closer in second place is Class Indian. Less than 2 lengths separates them as they race out of our view briefly. They come back into sight. Where's the Beef on top? Class Indian, though, moving alongside as they jump the next fence. And Golden Slammer has now moved within about 10 lengths of the lead. Where's the Beef making almost all of the running so far? Class Indian races closest to him in second place, and Golden Slammer completes our three-horse field as they race towards the next fence. Where's the Beef and Mark Beecher setting the pace? Right behind him, Class Indian. And another 5 lengths or so back to Golden Slammer, who races in third place. They race around the turn and head towards the next fence. Where's the Beef has now opened up his lead to about 4 lengths. Class Indian going evenly in second place, and it's about 5 more lengths back to Golden Slammer, who completes our three-horse field. As they go out of sight, Where's the Beef is on top by about 2.5 lengths. Class Indian is about 5 or 6 lengths clear of Golden Slammer, who completes the field. They have gone out of our view at this time. We've got a radio relay to the announcer.
Approaching fence 6.
They're approaching the 6th fence, I'm told. Where's the Beef, Class Indian, and Golden Slammer at the 6. There are several fences back there. We are having information related to us. At the 7th fence, Where's the Beef still has the lead. Class Indian follows in second place, and Golden Slammer is third. We should be getting another report. The order is the same over the 8th fence. That is, Where's the Beef on top, Class Indian in second, and Golden Slammer third. They should be coming back into our view shortly. Everybody stay clear of the fence back onto the course. It's still Where's the Beef, Class Indian, and Golden Slammer. And they come back into view and setting a leisurely pace now. Where's the Beef on top by about 4 lengths. Class Indian follows in second place, and Golden Slammer well within striking distance in third. They'll be coming down the hill shortly, heading towards the main race course. Where's the Beef has led almost every step of the way. Class Indian has been stalking him. Now Where's the Beef has dropped back into second place as Class Indian has gone to the front under Justin Basthoff. Class Indian on top. Where's the Beef in second place? Golden Slammer in third. Class Indian, going well on the front end, has widened his advantage to about 6, maybe 7 lengths, whereas the Beef, who set the pace most of the way, follows in second place, and now more separates those two, at least 8, 9, 10 lengths, as Class Indian is starting to draw away. Where's the Beef? Races in second place, and Golden Slammer and Forest Kelly are now moving up closer to Where's the Beef. They race around the turn. It's Class Indian and Justin Batoff setting the pace on top by at least a dozen, if not more, lengths. They race around the turn and head towards the next fence. Class Indian continues to set the pace now, as Where's the Beef races in second place and now drops back into third, and Golden Slammer is taking over second. Where's the Beef in third place? Still going at a nice pace. Golden Slammer has come from far out of it to take the lead. It's Golden Slammer on top. Class Indian following in second place. Where's the Beef is dropping back farther in third. Golden Slammer running and jumping with the lead. Class Indian right behind him as they race towards the next fence. I believe this is second fence from home. Golden Slammer and Forest Kelly took the lead about a quarter of a mile ago and now leads by maybe 5 or 6 lengths. They race into the turn. Class Indian is still going well and cuts the corner and goes to the front. But up on the outside, Golden Slammer regains the lead. Golden Slammer on top. Class Indian following in second place. And Where's the Beef with a bit of a rally in third. They turn for home with only one more fence to clear. Golden Slammer on the outside. Where's the Beef is there also. Class Indian in second place. Where's the Beef jumps in third and takes out a rail, racing through the stretch and heading for a home. Golden Slammer and Forest Kelly on top. Golden Slammer with the lead. Class Indian follows in second place. They head towards the finish. Golden Slammer on top. It's Golden Slammer holds him off and wins by about a length and a half. Golden Slammer, the winner. Golden Slammer, Class Indian, and Where's the Beef? The flag is up. And away they go. I think. On the corner goes to the front. On the corner leading towards the first fence under Alex Fulton. Durr follows in second place. Church Music in third. Super Saturday completes the field of 4 in fourth place. On the corner now picking up the pace a bit as he heads towards the first fence. On the corner over safely, followed by Durr. Super Saturday and Church Music completes the 4 horse field. On the corner went to the lead at the start, still maintaining about a 2.5 length advantage. Durr follows in second place, and it's about 6 lengths back to Super Saturday, with Church Music another 4 lengths farther back in fourth. Field is strung out just a bit as they go out into the country. On the corner with the lead, Durr follows in second place, Super Saturday in third. Church Music completes the field as they head towards, and the leaders are over the next fence. On the corner now has dropped back in the second place as Durr saved ground around the turn. On the corner has regained the lead. Durr follows in second place, and it's a good ways back to Super Saturday and Church Music, who completes the field. Racing towards the next fence, on the corner on top, Durr moving to within about 2.5 lengths of the leader in second place. Church Music is joined by Super Saturday. Those two racing as a team in third and fourth place. They've gone out of sight briefly. They come back in the view on the corner, and Alex Fulton still setting the pace. Durer and Mark Beecher in the pink cap races in second place. Church Music on the inside in third, with Super Saturday in fourth. They race towards the next fence with On the Corner on top. Durer follows in second place. Super Saturday and Gerard Galligan in third, with Church Music and Brett Owens right alongside. In fact, it's only about 3.5 lengths front to back in this four-horse field, as they'll be going out of sight briefly. On the Corner will show the way as they go out of sight. Durer about 1.5 lengths back in second place, and it's a gap of 2 more lengths to Church Music and Super Saturday, who complete the field. There are 3 fences at least that are out of our view. We will have word as they clear each of the fences on what the order is at that time. When they went out of sight, On the Corner had the lead. On the Corner, Durer, Super Saturday, and Church Music. Five has the lead at the sixth fence. Durer is running in second place. The field is tightly bunched. On the Corner heading towards the next fence. On the Corner on top. Durer in second place, only about 1.5 lengths off the lead. Church Music on the outside of Super Saturday. On the Corner, showing the way. Durer follows in second place, maybe about 2 lengths off the lead. Church Music and Super Saturday complete the field, but they're both only about 5 or 6 lengths. As they head towards the eighth fence, On the Corner continues to set the pace. Durer follows in second place, Super Saturday in third, and Church Music fourth, but only about 7 or 8 lengths off the lead. On the Corner continuing to make the running on the front end. Durer stalks him from second place, Super Saturday in third. Church Music is another 4 or 5 lengths farther back in fourth. They should be coming back onto the main course shortly. They've got another fence, though, on the backside, and that's On the Corner showing the way over that one, and Durer moves just a little bit closer in second place. Super Saturday well within striking distance in third, as is Church Music, who completes the field. They are coming back into sight briefly. On the Corner, Durer, Super Saturday, and Church Music. Strung out just a bit as they will be turning and heading down the hill towards the main course. On the Corner, our pace setter from the beginning. Durer has stalked him most of the way. They should be coming back into view. It's On the Corner on top. Durer is about 1.5 lengths or less behind, and Durer jumps to the lead under Mark Beecher as they come back onto the main course. On the Corner races in second place. Super Saturday in third, and Church Music follows in fourth place as they straighten away in the middle of the course. Durer and Mark Beecher now on top by about 1.25 lengths. Make it less than that as On the Corner moves alongside Durer. 3/4 of a length separates them. And here goes Church Music up on the outside to challenge for second. Loses just a bit of ground at that fence. Still anybody's horse race as they race towards the turn. On the Corner and Durer, those two are dueling for the lead. Church Music is about 3 lengths farther back, racing in third. And here comes Super Saturday on the inside to race in third place and moving towards the leaders. You can throw a big blanket over the field as Church Music is making a bold move up on the outside to take a slight advantage. On the Corner, coming back again on the inside under Alex Fulton to gain a lot of length advantage. Church Music in second place, Durer in third, and Super Saturday follows in fourth place. at the fence, on the corner, Durer, Church Music, Super Saturday. It's anybody's horse race here, as they've still got a good ways to go. They gallop towards the next fence, on the corner, continuing to set a pace. He's on top by about a length and a quarter. Racing in second place, Church Music. Super Saturday completes the field with Durer now moving up to challenge the leaders. There's three of them abreast across the course on the corner. Church Music, Durer now going to the front. Church Music in second place, Super Saturday in third. As they race away from us on the corner is last, but only about three lengths off the lead. Three abreast across that fence also, as Durer has the lead on the inside, Church Music on the extreme outside, Super Saturday is also there. Durer with less than a length advantage over Church Music. Church Music is about a half length or less behind as they turn for home. Durer, Church Music, and Super Saturday, they're all making a race of it as they turn for home. Durer, Church Music, Super Saturday on the corner. They've got one fence remaining. At the last fence, Church Music and Brett Owens have the advantage. Durer trying to get there. Super Saturday on the inside and on the corner there also. Racing towards the finish line. Church Music on top. Super Saturday on the outside and third with Durer. Church Music driving towards the finish line. Super Saturday and Durer trying to get there. Church Music by 2.5. trained by Cyril Murphy, ridden by Mark Beecher. Number 4, Girls Rule the World, is owned and ridden by Elizabeth Scully, trained by Mark Beecher. Number 5, Invocation, belongs to Straight Light Racing, LLC, trained by Leslie Young, ridden by Alex Leventhal. Number 6, Turf Stable LLC's Lawn Ranger, trained by Jonathan Shepard, ridden by Kerry Bryan. Number 7 is Apple Equipment and Amy Taylor Rose Polestar, trained by Leslie Young, ridden by Walter Puttifer. Number 9, Thistledown Farms Wildlife Artist, trained by Mark Beecher, ridden by Tate Shaw. Number 10, Ivy Hill Stable LLC's Beck's Bad Boy, trained by Alicia Murphy and ridden by Billy Santoro. Number 11, Stephanie W.S. Harper's Outlaw Cody Z, also trained by Alicia Murphy, ridden by Sarah Katz. Number 12, Mint Meadow Farms Final Heat, trained by Suzanne Stettinius, ridden by Hazel O'Neill. And completing our 11-horse field is number 13, Move Up Stables, It's Nothing, trained by Catherine Nelson, ridden by John Brophy. The field now lining up across the course. The flag is up. They're all in line, and away they go. Lawn Ranger on the inside, Henry Sand moving up on the extreme outside. Wildlife Artist now splitting horses and putting his head out in front. Henry Sand comes back again on the outside. Lawn Ranger has dropped back into fourth place. It's Nothing now moving up in the field. On the inside, as the field is tightly bunched, only about 8 or 9 lengths front to back. Wildlife Artist showing the way. Henry Sand right alongside. It's Nothing follows in third place. On the outside and fourth is Invocation, Beck's Bad Boy, Outlaw Cody Z, Lawn Ranger, Marsden Final Heat, Girls Rule the World with Polestar right alongside. They race towards the turn. Wildlife Artist and Tate Shaw. Right alongside him is Henry Sand and Mark Beecher. Those two are setting the pace, as this is the first of 2 times to go around the course. Wildlife Artist on the extreme outside now races in second place as Henry Sand saves ground on the inside and takes the lead. Wildlife Artist in second place, Invocation and It's Nothing. Those two vying for third. Right behind them, Beck's Bad Boy, Outlaw Cody Z. Lawn Ranger Polestar is there also with Marsden Final Heat and Girls Rule the World completes the field as they come into the stretch for the first of 2 times. Wildlife Artist in the black silks and the green silks with the white cap on the inside is Henry Sand. Those two have made most of the running on the front end. Invocation on the outside with It's Nothing there also as they race through the stretch for the first of 2 times to go around. Wildlife Artist, Invocation, Henry Sand. Invocation now going to the front. Invocation and Alex Leventhal with the lead. Henry Sand right alongside Henry Sand is Wildlife Artist. Beck's Bad Boy is there also with It's Nothing. Morrison has moved closer to the others with Outlaw Cody Z, Lawn Ranger Final Heat, Polestar, and Girls Rule the World completes the field. Invocation and Alex Leventhal now not only taking the lead, but sprinting away from this group, at least 12 to 15 lengths on top of Final Heat, who races in, not Final Heat, Henry Sand, who races in second place with Wildlife Artist right alongside. It's Nothing. Outlaw Cody Z moving up on the outside. Beck's Bad Boy is there also with Lawn Ranger completing the field as Girls Rule the World. Invocation's lead now is only about 4 lengths. As they race down the backside for the final time, Invocation on top. Henry Sand and Wildlife Artist dueling for second place. It's Nothing now moving up to challenge for second. It's Nothing in second place. Wildlife Artist Lone Ranger has moved closer to the others with Henry Sand there also. Beck's Bad Boy Outlaw Cody Z. The race is on the front end, where Alex Leventhal and Invocation still have a slight advantage. Wildlife Artist and Tate Shaw on the inside vying for the lead. Lone Ranger and Carrie Bryan moving up on the extreme outside with Invocation alongside. Lone Ranger now going to the front under Carrie Bryan. It's Lone Ranger who's going to lead into the stretch and try and hold off the rest of the field. Lone Ranger in the white silks on the outside. Wildlife Artist follows in second place. Invocation in third. It's Nothing is there also. Lone Ranger and Carrie Bryan now starting to draw away a bit from the field with the lead as they race into the final furlong. Lone Ranger and Carrie Bryan on top. Wildlife Artist, who's been going well throughout, trying to get there from second, but Lone Ranger is going to hold him off. Lone Ranger to win it by about four lengths. Lone Ranger, Wildlife Artist, is photo between Henry Sand and Marsden for third. Our riders are up in the paddock and the horses are now preparing to come onto the course for the seventh race, the Stoneworth Farm Training Flat, sponsored by Stoneworth Farm. Your field includes number one, Command Control, owned by Wits End Stable LLC, trained and ridden by William Dowling. Number two is Irvin S. Naylor's Saluda Sam, trained by William Meister, ridden by Manuel Aguilera. Number four, Jarrera, belongs to Irvin S. Naylor, trained by Cyril Murphy and ridden by Carol Ann Sloan. Number five, Duke of Medina, also belongs to Irvin S. Naylor, is also trained by Cyril Murphy and ridden by Daisy Fenwick. Number seven, Irvin S. Naylor's Jamarcho, trained by Leslie Young and ridden by Patty Young. Number eight, Sharon Shepherd's Kafaya, trained by Leslie Young and ridden by Trevor Ryan. And completing the field is number nine, In My Eyes, owned and trained by Danielle Hodgson, ridden by Sarah Katz. We need our timers to the stand. Oh, there they are. The flag is partially up. It's now up. They're all in line and away they go. out in the middle of the course, in my eyes on the inside. Saluda Sam goes to the front. Saluda Sam on top as they race straight towards us. The rest of them are tightly bunched. Duke of Medina on the outside, Jarir between horses, in my eyes, is there with Command Control, Kafaya, and completing the field is Jamarjo. One more time to go around. Saluda Sam on top under Manuel Aguilera. He's on top by about 8 or 9 lengths. Jarir now challenges for second place with In My Eyes right alongside. Duke of Medina saving ground on the inside with Jamarjo right behind him. And alongside is Kafaya as the field, except for the leader, is pretty tightly bunched. They head towards the backside of the course. Saluda Sam on top now by about 7 or 8 lengths. In My Eyes follows in second place. Jarir in third. Duke of Medina on the inside of Command Control. Kafaya and Jamarjo completes the field as they straighten away down the backside. Saluda Sam going well on the front end. Still holding on to about a 4.5 length advantage over Sarah Katz on In My Eyes. Jarir on the outside in third place with stablemate Duke of Medina right alongside. Command Control with Jamarjo and Kafaya completing the field as they race towards the turn. Saluda Sam has led from the early stages. In My Eyes closest to him in second place. Jamarjo and Patty Young are now making a big move up on the inside. They've taken over second and moving towards the leader. And Kafaya has rallied also under Trevor Ryan. As they race into the turn, Saluda Sam still has the lead. In My Eyes coming back again to take over second place with Jamarjo now racing in third. Kafaya has moved into fourth place. Saluda Sam has dropped from the lead back to and also ran right now as they turn for home. Saluda Sam trying to find his way on the inside, might be pulling up. We'll see. As they race into the final furlong, Command Control and Willie Dowling going to the front on the outside. Jamarjo, though, on the inside. Kafir is there also. Kafir has the lead as they head towards the finish line. It's Jarir on top by about 6 lengths.
Field. Number one out of the fire belongs to 3G Stables LLC, trained and ridden by William Dowling. Number three is Oksa O'Donovan's I Gotta Dance, trained by Alyssa Murphy, ridden by Billy Santoro. Number four is Irvin S. Naylor's Hooded, trained by Cyril Murphy and ridden by Mark Beecher. Number five, Tubal, also belongs to Irv Naylor and is also trained by Cyril Murphy, ridden by Carol Ann Sloan. Number six, Jonathan Shepherd's Expecting, is trained by the owner and ridden by Gerard Galligan. And completing our six-horse field is number eight, Bally Bristol Farm LLC's Andy Amu, trained by Leslie Young, ridden by Patty Young. The horses are now on course, warming up on their way to the start.
Our field is now under starter's orders.
Very good.
They're lining up the course across the course. The flag is up. And away they go. Hooded in the middle of the course. Goes to the front, out of the fire, moving up on the outside. Andy Amu is there also. As this is the first time through the stretch, they'll come through the stretch once again. I Got a Dance has gone to the front under Billy Santoro. Tubal is racing in second place with Carol Ann Sloan up. Andy Amu is there also with Out of the Fire. Hooded and Expecting completes the field. I Got a Dance on top with one more time to go around. Tubal follows in second place. Andy Amu Out of the Fire. Hooded and Expecting completes the field. Racing towards the turn. I Got a Dance and Billy Santoro have set most of the pace so far. Tubal and Carol Ann Sloan sitting right behind him in second place. Andy Amu follows in third. Out of the Fire. Hooded on the inside of Expecting, who completes the field, but's only about 7 lengths off the lead. I Got a Dance on top by about 2 lengths. Tubal follows in second place. Out of the Fire and Willie Dowling on the outside in third, with Andy Amu and Patty Young racing in fourth. Expecting is there also, with Hooded alongside. Anybody's horse race, they've got a little bit more than 5/8 of a mile to go. I Got a Dance showing the way most of the race. Tubal follows in second place. Andy Amu in third. Out of the Fire on the outside. Close up in fourth place. Hooded is there with Expecting right alongside. Still anybody's horse race as they've got less than a half mile to go. I Got a Dance is on top by a little bit more than a length. Tubal follows in second place with Andy Amu on the outside in third. Out of the Fire races in fourth place with Hooded on the inside and Expecting now moving up on the outside under Gerard Galligan. I Got a Dance though has the lead as they race midway around the turn. I Got a Dance on top. Tubal follows in second place. Out of the Fire and Willie Dowling are moving up on the outside to challenge for second as they race towards us with less than a quarter of a mile to go. Tubal has gone to the front. Hooded is moving up on the inside. Expecting on the extreme outside. Out of the Fire is there also. As they race towards the finish, Expecting has gone to the lead under Gerard Galligan. Expecting is on his way to victory here and wins it by a little bit more than length. Make it a length and a quarter. Tubal runs in second place.